The sharp recovery from June lows has helped benchmark indices recoup all the year-to-date losses. The YTD gains for benchmark Nifty 50 and Sensex indices now stands at over 1%. In comparison, global peers across the US, Asia, and Europe are down in the range of 2 to 42%. Analysts say the one-way rally over the past 2 months has been triggered by strong foreign portfolio investments, drop in commodity prices, and hopes of less aggressive rate hike by the Reserve Bank of India. They also expect India's relative outperformance to continue as it looks better placed with a healthy economic recovery and remains one of the fastest growing major economies. So, which are the stocks and sectors that should be on your radar? Analysts say investors should start nibbling in stocks with a focus towards the domestic economy related sectors.
In the emerging global recessionary scenario, India stands out as a shining light. The reason for this is in a recession in the advanced economies, oil and commodity prices will tend to ease, and India as a global importer of oil and commodities will tend to benefit. The government's infrastructure capex drive is well known, and private sector capex is also reviving. Hence, I would say that the infrastructure related sectors like building materials, cement, steel, capital goods are probably the sector which is going to benefit the most. The second sector benefiting from a dropping commodity price is the consumption sector, notably discretionary consumption, including automobiles and housing. And the third overarching sector, which is largely domestically focused, benefits strongly from both the investment and the discretionary consumption, is the banking and financial services sector.
Nitin Raheja of Julius Baer Wealth Advisors too has a similar view.
Going for the year, I think India is expected to have one of the highest GDP growth rates. Now, when we talk about this, some of the sectors that we look very, very positive on are in financials, and we like the entire financial space, right, from private banks, public banks, insurance companies. The other segment is consumption-oriented. We see real estate as a segment doing well. Correspondingly, you know, mortgage finance, home improvement, building materials, and hiring companies.
Among individual stocks, analysts say export-oriented themes may give muted returns in the near term. Thus, one could focus on domestically focused stocks like L&T, Ultratech Cement, JK Cement, Tata Communication, Indraprastha Gas, GAIL, Brigade Enterprise, Tata Motors, Ashok Leyland, Dabur India, Jyoti Labs, Sapphire Food, SBI, IndusInd, and SBI Card. That said, weak global demand and uncertainty with respect to global energy situation makes India vulnerable with respect to inflation, current account deficit, corporate profitability, and currency. On Friday, markets will react to the European Central Bank's interest rate decision and assess US Fed Chair Jerome Powell's speech at the Cato Institute's conference. That apart, oil prices, dollar index movement, and stock-specific cues will guide the indices.
If you like this video, share it and subscribe to Business Standard. For more news, views, and insights, log on to www.business-standard.com. Do also follow us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Telegram, and LinkedIn.